guys, I'm just a little upset that you guys have already not subscribed to Books on Toast, because that's ridiculous. Subscribe to Books on Toast, because we all know that we're a little insecure about books, and these guys will tell you exactly what to read so that you sound amazing and good, you know, also make sense. So subscribe to Books on Toast today, share this, and share your love also, man.
Yeah, love is good to share.
If it's not an STD, this could be an STD. Yeah, right?
Yes.
Guess who's on BoTCast?
Yes.
This one, right?
It's so cute.
Everybody wants a piece of this, but only a Books on Toast gets it.
Yeah, BoTCast.
It's Sumukhi on Toast. Books on Sumukhi.
I just want to say thank you to all those people who tweeted at her after Naveen's episode asking her to come.
Yeah, they were.
Clearly, me texting her every week for the last year was not enough.
No, that was enough, but I was like, okay, so you're texting me.
She was being like busy and like doing things.
I think because I didn't text her.
I think there is something there. Also, there were people who've got very like, oh, do you not like Anuya Jakadar? Is that what it is? I'm like, wait, 1 minute. Before this blows out of proportion, because I look like a person who hate people. I don't want to go through that.
She's not actually Pushpavalli.
I'm not, guys, please.
Yeah, she isn't.
She's relax, okay?
She's the most gentle puppy
exactly.
in the world.
Exactly. If I want you, if I like you, I upfront come and talk to you. I would not find out your mom's sunshine.
Okay.
Anyway, on that note.
Thank you, Sumukhi, for joining us for a great episode of the BoTCast. We, by the way, are very prescriptive. We already know whether our podcast is supposed to be great, fantastic, brilliant.
She always opens with great episode, fantastic episode. I'm like, isko pata hai, fantastic hone
wala. Amazing. Just in case you're confused, I'll tell you what
we don't lack in confidence.
It's a great positive attitude.
It's very positive.
Can I say I'm very nervous, intimidated, excited.
What?
Because both of you, I think, read too much.
And also, we are very sexy.
That too. Sexy readers.
Yeah.
And also, okay, this is also because I come from personal experience of, I live in Anuya's ex-room.
Yeah.
And Anuya's ex-room is filled with books and everyone comes into my room. And you know, ladies, when that happens. And then they come in and then they look at those books and they're like, wow, do you read? And I say, yeah.
Because I'm not read.
I'm not read a single book from that. But I'm like... Yeah.
But that's true actually. Books do help you get literary lay.
Literally laid.
Wow.
That should be a t-shirt.
Literally laid. If you'd like to be literally laid, don't tell us, it's weird. But like, do tweet to BoTCast.
Yes.
Okay, Sumukhi, what are you reading right now?
Oh, guys, I just finished a graphic novel which I don't read. I get very worried with graphic novels. Because I feel like it's too much pressure, because it's a conversation at bars. It's between cool people who wear like t-shirts and then great shoes. And I don't want to be part of that, because they're like, oh my God, do you know this cartoon? And this cartoon killed this cartoon.
Okay, one second. Hold it. It's not a cartoon. It's a comic.
Comic! So, I mean, not a comedian comic. Like a comic.
Oh my God! I love how comedians think comic is comedian. It's so sad.
But I get very like, hurry, I don't know this. I don't know Star... And I think at one point I confused Star Wars and Batman and people really lost their shit.
How?
Because I'm like, well, all of them, aren't they fighting for justice?
Like Darth Vader and Batman? Did you confuse them?
Yeah.
What's a Darth Vader now?
Okay, that's going to be a whole other episode.
Exactly.
Educating Sumukhi on pop culture.
So that's why I got...
this is.
Yeah, please do. That would really help me. So a friend of mine gave me this book saying that's a graphic novel. I'm like, as a principal, I don't, because I'm Luna class. I'm not middle class or poverty. I'm Luna class. I'm like, I don't read that. He's like, no, it's about the Holocaust. You must read it. It's called Mouse.
And, oh, I love Mouse.
And I read it and oh my God, it's... So
amazing.
Good.
Very dark, right?
Yeah, and I couldn't stop reading it. I just kept reading it. And this is me. When I don't read. But when I read, it's the only thing I do.
Wow.
So it's a little... we got a little intense. I was very intense.
Mouse is amazing.
Mouse
please
is
read
really
it.
Good. We've spoken about it a lot in our graphic novels
episode. Yeah.
God,
but
much.
Yeah, it's quite nice. So speaking of Luna class, thanks for the lovely title, by the way. the topic of our BoTCast today is Indian fiction.
Yeah, I know.
A
lot of people have asked for it. And I also ran a poll a few days ago asking everybody on Twitter to tell me what Indian fiction they're reading. And I was quite, actually not surprised, I was expecting this, but true to form, you guys did prove to me that the only two Indian fiction writers that you guys are reading or are aware of are Chetan Bhagat and Amish. Mm-hmm. So, we know that this is a problem.
Amish is not that bad, but...
You've read Amish?
Yeah.
With the Sita
series? Yeah, Sita one. Yeah. And
what did you think?
It's just nice. Huh. I was like, okay. The thing is, it didn't stick with me. This is the thing, if I'm reading... and it sticks with me, or if it's left a visual, then fine. It didn't leave a visual. Having said that, Chetan Bhagat on the other hand did leave a visual. Something.
Which Sita book did you read?
Which one? The Immortals of Meluha, na?
No, that Meluha.
Oh, that's not, that's Shiva.
Yeah,
no,
so Shiva trilogy.
I have not read Amish Tripathi.
I unfortunately have read all Amish Tripathi. I am not ashamed to say it. So he's written two volumes, two trilogies. One is the Shiva trilogy, which is the Immortals of Meluha trilogy. And then, of course, the other one, which is the Ramchandra series, which is about Ram. But the one thing that I didn't like about Amish Tripathi is the fact that he oversimplified mythology. Yeah. Like the part where he says, chill Parvati. And I'm like, I don't hear Shiva saying chill Parvati.
It suddenly became a sketch. I'm like, why did you do that? It's weird. The thing is, Parvati chill, is the kind of person, if you go tell her chill, she'd be like, excuse me, did you just fucking say chill to me? She seems
also
that
like,
type.
Chill, Parvati.
See? Eh. No,
dodged the bullet.
The Chetan Bhagat, on the other hand, I'm not a hater. I loved 5.someone. I truly did. I think it was very nicely written. It was very, it's something like, it's almost like someone's talking to you. But after that, it just went downhill. Like, especially that one night at call center was just like, why? Why, Chetu? Why?
I think 5.someone was a good book, to be honest. Like, I read it and it's not bad. But I think he just ruined a good premise by writing about it over and over again. Yeah. That's possibly
It's kind of average looking guy has a girl and then there's this really hipster looking boy. I'm like,
which
great.
Is what makes it great on
But
TV.
I feel like that's why it's relatable. He writes great stories.
Yeah.
I remember reading 5.someone in FIJC. Where everyone was reading it, and I was really excited that there was an Indian author writing about things that I could relate to. And I picked up
college
life. Was so bad. And in FIGC, I'd already reached Gone with the Wind level, right? I'm already 16. I've read so many books that I am expecting a certain basic grammar and like punctuation and craft that comes with a book. That is my expectation. My problem with 5.someone was, even when I was in FIGC doing science, I didn't know I was going to be a writer. I want to take a red pen, sit and just like fucking edit the shit out
that
of it. Like just like
publisher.
Wrong sentence construction.
I do get it. Like, you know, especially for a reader who's read so well.
Yeah.
Chetan Bhagat is not something.
But then maybe he's not for me.
I didn't hate it. I'm like, hey man, you know what? You gave an underdog story. Uh-huh. But can underdog stop winning? It's over. It's not a thing.
Yeah.
What's the next story?
Yeah.
What's the next story?
Once again, there's an underdog from a different state liking a girl from. Oh, come on, Chetu.
Yeah. Two states now, not just one.
It's two states. So, whatever. Yes.
So, Chetan Bhagat.
Yeah, but what have you guys grown up reading? Like, what is your earliest memory of reading about India or Indian fiction?
So, my family is big on reading. Except my mom, my brothers and my father. My father's MA literature, major reader. Oh. He read Tamil literature just for the kicks. He's like, I'm bored, why don't I read Tamil literature? I'm like, you're a freak show, you continue with what you're doing.
I think he and I can be friends.
And we will not talk. So, my brother's also very good reader. So for me, it was more like a, you know, I wanted to be like, I don't want to read fiction. I don't want to read what you're reading. I'll read things that you guys are not reading. So I started Indian fiction like that. And honest to God, I started, my first book, Indian fiction, was Salman Rushdie. I didn't understand anything.
Oh my God.
8th standard. I was like, oh my God, this is like this. Yeah. I think it was one of his earlier books and my brother's like, how are you liking it? I'm like, it's amazing. Yeah. And then I just tossed it out. But then I reconnected with it in like first year, second year. And it made so much
sense.
Which
book was it?
I remember the one which I picked up, the first Salman Rushdie book was, Shalimar the Clown.
Ah.
That book has so much feels.
It does.
That's a lot of feels. This man, this clown just takes so much out of me. That's the thing also with
That's
Indian...
That's what she said.
It's also what happened actually. Anyway, it's also, I feel like Indian fiction, I may be wrong here, is that they give you a visual of the people involved. They're not very good with their environments. Like you read Ruskin Bond and you're like, oh my God. You can see the whatever he's picture. It's very picturesque. But with Indian fiction, there are a lot of relationships that you feel, that you understand.
That is true.
For me, Indian fiction has a lot to do with relationships rather than the environment.
And understanding the differences between upper middle class, lower middle class. That's exactly how we figured out that this was a class distinction by reading a lot of Indian fiction. Which is what a lot of early Indian fiction was also about. Like, Khushwant Singh wrote about that. There was a lot of partition. I grew up on a lot of partition. Only because, I mean, I am from the north. Partition land that I literally got partitioned. So, but all Khushwant Singh was about that. Sadat Hasan Manto was about that. So, I, of course, like, read a lot of translated versions. I could not, like, read the originals. But it really put, like, a face to the tragedy. Which is about human displacement, right? But who are these humans getting displaced?
Yep.
And I suppose that's how we related, which is exactly what Luna class is.
It's exactly what Luna class is.
That
yeah.
is what it is.
Luna driving people whose relationships are way more.
Yeah.
That even if it's a 1 BHK, 2 BHK, you get it.
Yeah.
It's one of those things.
This conversation reminds me of reading Rohinton Mistry.
I was just like, itna dukhi kyun hai ye sab sad. Every stage pe it just gets worse.
It gets worse.
I'm like, ab khushi aayegi? Nahin. Ab? Oh no.
Yeah.
Ab? No.
Like, I mean, it belonged to a time where the middle class was struggling as opposed to now where the middle class is flourishing.
Correct.
And, so, and you know, I think this is the fine balance, no?
Such a long journey.
That fine balance.
Which was
oh.
such a long journey.
I remember I read the fine balance and can I tell you, it was based around 1975,
emergency.
They were talking about Sanjay Gandhi doing the, you know, the whole Hum Do, Hamare Do Na. And
sterilization drive.
And you were there in it. It's,
yeah.
It was very it's scary
really
to read.
Yeah.
And it's there was one particular, very, not gross, but very, I don't know the word, maybe help me out here. Is that there was one particular bit in the book where the owner of the house, this guy who's a tailor and the tailor's assistant, they all live together in a house. And then how it started with, she's like, I didn't like using the bathroom because, you know, the smell, the stench of the urine is really bothering me. And she's like, and 1 week passed by and I realized it stops stinking because we all were eating the same thing. So it didn't make sense. And I think what he wanted to say was that, oh, wastage is the same from humans. But I'm like, but this, I don't know.
Yeah.
Too much.
Such a long journey is about that one middle class man and his family. And of course, it's Parsi and all the bad things that happened to them over time. And that was my one Rohinton Mistry book, which I finished. It was wonderfully written, you know, and all of that. In fact, I had to study it as a part of my MA because I needed an extra 16th year to be able to study in the States. So I did MA literature through like Mumbai University.
So this was prescribed reading material?
Yeah, they gave us such a long journey. One of the courses, 100 Years of Solitude, which I'd already read, Don Quixote, and fucking Virginia Woolf, whom I wanted to the Lighthouse.
But why did they pick such a long journey?
I don't know.
It's a very strange.
Yeah, I don't know. Or maybe I'm mixing two different. Maybe there was an Indian fiction. But I remember reading that book for that and wondering why it was so relentlessly sad.
Yeah, it was. He just beat by beat just gets worse.
Yeah.
Like Rohinton Mistry is that guy who'll be like, why don't you have happy endings? He's that guy who'll give you, be like, no!
Life mein nahi hota happy.
Nahi hota. 1970 mein happy ending nahi ho raha tha. Shole bhi flop hua.
But this is also true, right? Like this is all stories of India, like pre-liberalization.
Yeah.
Like the whole Rajiv Gandhi sort of revolution did not. No, like Rajiv Gandhi brought out liberalization to India, right? In 1991. Before that, we didn't even have cable television. This is Doordarshan era, right?
Yeah.
It is somewhat a era of darkness because there is so much.
You know. Who did Doordarshan era but introduced me to it really, really well? And this is also a good segue to talk about like newer literature.
Contemporary literature
is Anuja Chauhan in Pricey Thakur Girls.
Oh yeah, she did talk about this one bit.
So Anuja Chauhan we've covered. She is,
but
I think, India's best.
I think I love like...
Chiclet, although I don't want to slot her in that space, but... I think the first Indian book that I read that I felt spoke my language was Anuja Chauhan. And it doesn't cut corners like Chetan Bhagat. It isn't badly written.
It's very...
It is wonderfully written.
It's Indian English.
Yeah.
But grammatically correct Indian English.
Yeah.
So, which is a good thing, right? Because, I mean, and she's also from an advertising background. She had worked on the Pepsi commercial.
Yes.
Oh.
And she brings in a lot of those quirks and nuances to her writing. And at no point do you feel like you are not reading well. It's very well written.
Yeah.
Oh, I read The Zoya Factor.
Yes.
Yeah, so she's written The Zoya Factor, which we've spoken spoken about earlier. And then Battle of Bitora, which is a very interesting book again about
politics.
About two rival houses in UP whose scions are entering politics.
And of course,
and
they,
they have a crush on each other. So, you know, like this. Yeah, exactly. And they're kind of like, yeah, doing all that.
Well, you know, it gets political all the time.
Very literally lace. Yeah. So, but it's really nice, like, because both of them carry a lot of baggage of how they grew up.
Yeah.
And again, there is a lot of, you know, like, you understand Lucknow a lot better. Because it is about UP. It's a lot about, I mean, in the background, there's a lot of gangster wars happening. There's, like, you know, political legacy being carried forward. I think, you know, like, for people who are interested in Gandhi and this is the Gandhi legacy, this is not, like, Aligarh, but it's somewhere in the area. And this is true about UP politics, you know. Like, people are very proud of their legacies, right? And this is when personality and legacy clash, because the younger lot don't really care about it, or that's what they don't, right?
Yeah.
And then there is that. That is the complexity in which this book is built.
Exactly. And still it's a love story.
And it's a love story at the end.
It's a love story.
But you know, it also tells you, especially with Indian fiction, is the only place where I've seen there's such different cultures being explored. It's also because there's so many things within one. It's the reason why if you read a fiction book from abroad or a writer from another culture, it's pretty straightforward. In the end, you know this is how it's going to be a certain way. Like a person, a love story as simple as from a UP is going to be very different.
Yeah.
Another region is going to be different.
Yeah.
Political backgrounds are going to be different. So it's every state has a different story to tell. You, of course, get it when a Rohinton mystery just goes depressed. Thoda zyada aur. So it makes sense.
Correct.
In Pricey Thakur Girls also, she does that really well. So it's set in, I think, the early 90s in the Delhi. No, 80s.
Where,
80s, and she wants to be a TV reporter. Her dream is to go on Doordarshan and be a reporter.
Oh man.
And the guy is investigating a really big scam.
Yeah.
So how their lives collide and how that all takes place in that exact milieu in, you know, that's in Delhi, and her sisters and their lives and how things were different for women at that time.
Correct.
You know, so it just, for me, it was like, wow, this is such a great introduction.
It is.
Yeah, and nobody is writing about this, right? I'm not I'm getting like dukh, dard, partition, emergency.
Yeah, to partition, emergency, or yeah. Yeah. Indian fiction.
That,
That's like me, but in the 80s. Like, you
Indian
know?
Fiction, right now, what is going on is very yuppie.
Yeah.
It's very Indian fiction, jo cafe jaate hain, aur cold coffee peete hain. I'm like, arey, yaar, chai bhi to peete hain log.
chai
drinking modern people.
Anuja Chauhan is kind of like what Chetan Bhagat we all deserve.
That's a great line. So, yeah,
it is. And also in the Pricey Thakur Girls, Delhi is a great character.
Yeah.
So it talks about like this. I remember this one sequence where, you know, they're talking about all the women from Lajpat Nagar, which is like this one upmarket South Delhi place. And no, I think it's West Delhi. And
I don't know about upmarket.
We're being very racist.
Well, I mean, if you've lived in Delhi or you are from Delhi, you know what I'm talking about.
Okay,
So, there's this whole part where, you know, they're trying to build how the women from there are, and they all wear matching things. So, you know, that thing she keeps playing in the show, like, everything will be matching, from your salwar kameez to your earrings to your makeup to your bindi, everything is matching. And this is true about women who grew up in Delhi.
They all play a card game who's called what?
Pabo, I think, if I'm not wrong.
I don't know what it's called. Some
we'll weird
put it
like
here.
Delhi.
Wow. It's a very strange
thing.
Yeah,
it's very... But it's very Delhi. So if you have any sort of idea about Delhi culture at
or even if you don't...
Yeah,
it's
gotta
a great
find
introduction.
Out.
So yeah. Mm-hmm. And in fact, so there's another author, Rana Das Gupta. He is he's British Indian, and he wrote this book on Delhi, which I think was called Capital. It's a non-fiction book. It's like what Suketu Mehta did for Bombay in Maximum City. He did for Delhi in Capital. And there is a lot of like universe building about how Delhi's like culture works, right? Like, so there is extreme politics, extreme journalism on the other end. Also very, very rich people who live on the outskirts. And then how their worlds collide and how the power play works. And it's great to know that about a city that you don't have a connection with.
Yeah.
This is what Murakami does for Japan. For
she knows so much. She threw three names in one. I'm like, oh my God, ab kis kis ko yaad rakhu main?
So
Suketu Mehta.
Then Murakami.
Bhai, Suketu Mehta mat padho.
Yeah. Suketu Mehta is the book you give people who don't know anything about Bombay, who want like a...
No, don't do that. Somebody
foreigners love... No, no, no. If you know Bombay, then you shouldn't read Suketu Mehta.
It's...
Then don't know, if you don't know me, it's like a great introduction.
But if you... Yeah, but if you want to like... Chal, terko kuch to samajhna chahiye na, chaliye padh le.
Yaar, bahut boring hai kitab.
Yeah, yeah.
Mat padho, yaar.
No, hum likhenge.
Traffic signal pe sab bechte hai, mat lo.
You know, it's also a really good time to be writing good contemporary Indian
fiction.
Yes,
that's very true. Yeah.
If you have a good book, publish it now because there are likely chances it will become a Netflix series.
Very high.
Or, which is great.
Yeah. But also, I mean, it's a very few, this is not even Indian fiction, very few directors or very few writers have the capability of taking book and converting into a movie.
Hmm.
I mean, I'm digressing. I'm so sorry. As much as Harry Potter, everybody loves, didn't.
Hate the movies.
I hate the movies.
Hate the movies.
Harry Potter should have been a TV series. It should have been a series which gives as much attention. Because the thing about books. Yeah, the thing about books is also because side characters have equal to give. Something as small as a Fred and George, actually not even something as small. Fred and George was just not there in the movie, which bothers me. So even if you're writing, don't think about, oh, it's going to be published as a...
No, don't think about, oh, it's going to be made into a screen.
Yeah, you'd rather just write it.
But write it. Write,
like,
do, be true.
I think the number of times we've spoken about a suitable boy being, oh man.
So fun story, Sumukhi and I bonded over our love for suitable boy.
God, that book.
Yeah. Is we met so and good. We suddenly have... I don't know why we started talking about Vikram Seth. But we started talking about Vikram Seth and how much we love Suitable Boy.
That book is... It's huge. It's 1,396 pages.
It's the longest.
It's the one of the biggest and fattest Indian books ever published.
And what a book. What a fact that it's exploring four different families.
Yeah.
It's talking about things which... It's apparently at core value a love story, which is not.
Not at all.
It's not.
That premise of a girl looking for... Choosing a suitor out of three men is so misleading.
Yeah.
Because it's not that, it's just politics and like society
there,
and just...
There's
like,
everything, isn't there? Politics, there's like cheating, there's sex. Affair ho raha hai, sex chal raha hai, dange ho raha hai, I'm like, kya ho raha hai?
I remember reading, reading it then and thinking this will make a superb TV show.
What a TV show.
And guess what's happening.
Yeah.
And we were very upset because we were like...
Hum karenge.
And hum waise bhi karenge.
Lekin hamari aukaat nahi thi,
Sumukhi. It's true.
Sumukhi, let's just face facts, okay? We would have shat on that book.
That is true.
It was an amazing book.
No, actually, you know what? Maybe it deserves, but yeah.
I mean,
it hurts.
Yeah.
Like, the Chatterjees and their little couplets, it's just, it's so much. My brother and I have bonded on the line. Cuddles, cuddles, dear dog.
Oh my God.
Go bite Sir Stuart Hogg. What is Krishna in the end? Just a mushroom. I still remember it. Just a mushroom, just a friend. And this is the thing you hardly remember.
You know what? I remember the gay sex scenes.
Oh yeah, which one was that?
I don't remember.
Was
the
it
name.
Dipankar or the other?
His name?
No, not Dipankar. The
was it
other guy?
Arun's the younger brother. That is the Rupa's brother.
Yes, that was my introduction to gay sex scenes. By the way,
it was beautifully
written. And then I found out that Vikram Seth was gay,
and
then I read
I didn't know that.
Buddy!
Oh my God!
He's okay, the most famous!
Yeah. Okay, I'll give you context, guys. And Sumukhi also.
Yeah.
So when the Section 377 first came out and there was media about it, he officially came out in public for India Today. So there was this one big story and a beautiful photo, like a very POV photo of just him in this really like messed up state, like looking up like pleadingly at the world, ke accept me.
Hmm.
And he wrote a poem for India Today where he comes out. He's the most openly
gay or Indian. Yeah.
I think
author.
I'm just so focused.
And that's why he ran away also.
Oh well, that's sad. Yeah.
It's a, I mean, so about a boy could be him, you know, like it's real.
But that
about
book,
a boy.
That book, no, the
section,
book, yeah.
The gay.
But that book, I mean, if you haven't read it, please, that's one of those things where annually once a year, I just take it up, I'm like, I'm not going to read anything, I'm going to read this again.
Yeah, I want to reread it. I was very young when I read it. Yeah. Now I remember very little.
Even if you read it last year, I'm like, this year I've become a better person, I might just understand. Like that quote of food that Saida, I was... For the longest, didn't understand the first time. Second time I read, I'm like, oh my God. Third time, I was
her. You've read Suitable Boy 3 times.
I've read 4 times.
You know what? After this podcast, I'm going to go home and I'm going to reread Suitable Boy.
I've read it a lot of times.
But if you haven't read it, if you have the time and the patience.
No, it's a great book to read.
Somebody, it's a commitment.
Yeah. It is. It's
like a few years ago, a friend of mine was just getting into rereading again, and she had lost the habit, like all of us do at some point.
Yeah,
give up the good habit for bad habits. But so she asked me, and I told her to read A Suitable Boy, and she was just immersed. It also hooks you.
Yeah,
so much. For the volume it is, it's a very pacey read.
It did bore me.
You will feel like you'll dive into it immediately, and there'll be nothing that'll bore you. There's not one extra word. It's very well written.
Although I didn't like Rupa so much.
She was okay.
She's okay. I'm just like, whatever. You're fair.
So, Suitable Boy is being adapted by BBC. It's being directed by Meera Nair.
In case Meera, I'm right here. Okay. Yes.
You want some comedy?
Or I can cry also.
Cry.
I can cry.
Yeah.
Cry. I will.
Show her this.
Okay.
Is
your one. I'm trying.
Okay. Your dog just died.
I'm not sad about that.
Your dog ate your cat.
I got a dog. That's sad.
Your flatmate is eating your dog.
That's funny.
This is weird.
But I will send you my work, Meera Nair, where I can cry. Right now, the thing is, I'm not attached to dogs. So if there are dog-related roles, just don't give that to me. Having said that, you, me, crying machine.
And adaptations.
Speaking of Vikram Seth, there's also Vikram Chandra. Yes. Whose Sacred Games is turning into a Netflix special.
Netflix.
Show. With Saif Ali Khan in it.
Show.
And Radhika Apte.
Woo! And Phantom is making
and
it.
And Nawazuddin Siddiqui.
Yeah, I have a lot of
hope. It's going to be fantastic. And also, Vikram Chandra, I don't know if you guys know this, Vikram Chandra and Tanuja Chandra and Upama Chopra are all siblings.
Yeah.
What?
They come from a family of writers. And we discovered this when Tanuja came on our show.
Dushman Lady?
The Dushman Lady.
And oh, man, I love her.
Yeah.
Oh, my God, you guys know her?
Yeah, she
Okay, Tanuja, listen to me, okay? You, me, crying machine. Again. Okay, I could totally be a Dushman in your set. The worst pickup lines for Tanuja Chandra ever.
Yeah. Hey, baby, I can be the Sangharsh in your pants.
In your, Knock, knock. Who's there? Two kajols.
You can kill one if you want.
Yeah. I would give a bad egg. Anyway, we should stop.
Oh my God, guys. So, Vikram Chandra also wrote a weird thing about him. Vikram Chandra and Suketu Mehta both co-wrote Mission Kashmir. That was directed by Vikram.
No wonder!
I was just like, what is happening? This Chandra family, na?
But that movie was insane. Really? Mm-hmm. I'm sorry, I really liked that movie. Really? A lot of people are like, oh my God, how can you like Mission Kashmir? I'm like, because Hrithik Roshan's acting in it.
Hrithik Roshan vibrates anyway.
But he still vibrated very well.
Okay.
Great vibrations.
Another book that I'm super excited about watching the Netflix show is Leela by Prayag Akbar. We covered this in our Best Indian Fiction of last year episode.
And it's a dystopian Indian fiction, which is very interesting about it.
So, which was in itself a unique thing for me to find a book that was... Dystopia is my favorite genre, as everybody knows.
I know what you guys are thinking, and I'll ask it. What's a dystopian?
Okay.
Dystopia, the world is coming
I'm
to an
asking.
End.
Yeah, dystopia is the opposite of utopia. Dystopia. And to find good Indian fiction that's dystopian and set in India was like my dream.
Okay.
And I have found it.
I'm still to read it. Yeah. I know it's really
it's
bad.
It's a book called Leela.
Now that I know what dystopian is, I'll read it.
And Prayag Akbar is also a journalist.
He's a journalist. All these journalists, please go for it. Write great books like this, like Manu Joseph and
Somebody we've spoken about so many times.
Like
also
Leela.
Journalist. Yeah.
like Leela. Also a book called Miss Leela.
Miss Leela, Armed and Dangerous.
Yeah.
And Serious Men. And The Illicit Happiness of Other People.
But Leela is so unique in its existence that its language is Indian, but its setting and storytelling and is international. Like anybody can pick it up and read it and love it.
Oh.
And it's about a woman's search for her lost daughter in a world where boundaries are made around people based on caste, even though he will not say caste. Mm. He doesn't say caste. Mm. But it's all caste system manifesting geographically, where people choose to live in communities where the walls have been built on the basis of caste. You can't enter and exit as you want.
Wow.
And the lead story is about a Muslim and Hindu, of course.
Reading it.
Yeah, getting married and having a baby.
This is a good.
You know, this could actually be happening right now.
Dude,
that's
the worst part about reading that book. Where you're like, ye toh 20 saal baad, iska naam rakho.
You know, something which I do worry, and I don't know if we will get the opportunity with the way things are, is mythology being you know, the way our mythological stories and the kind of stories that we have being used to write newer versions, that has always been like, this is like my gift book. I gift this to everyone. The Palace of Illusions, I know a lot of them are like, oh my god, I don't know if it's factually right. I'm like, you know what, screw you.
One second. Factually, matlab kya?
Yeah, exactly. You know what, so many people get very offended. Like, recently had a conversation saying, I love the Palace of Illusions. He said, I have the worst version ever. How can they mess with facts?
Was that a man?
Of course. And I'm like, buddy, but it's the Palace of Illusions. The whole beauty of this book is that it's the conversation or the whole exposition of Mahabharata through Draupadi, who is a flawed woman, which is fine.
I was going to ask you what the book is about. Tell people what it is
about. Okay, Palace of Illusions, the entire Mahabharata in the, you know, you're reading the
Draupadi's
whole thing from Draupadi's point of view. And it's so refreshing. It makes each and every character, including Lord Krishna, human, which is the best thing ever. Otherwise, you're not going to understand relationships at all.
And also, while on that, it explores the relationship between Draupadi and Krishna.
A lot.
Nobody has touched
on. And so ever. Nicely written. Yeah. And can I tell you also, I know they kind of straight saying that Draupadi was actually in love with Karna.
How do we know if it's straight?
Exactly. That's also true. But
it's a story. They're all stories. It's not real, guys.
Beautifully written.
I mean, well, it's Padmavati.
But yeah. but literally, this one, Draupadi and the... such little interactions between Draupadi and Karna, and so beautifully written. I've never read sexual chemistry or romantic chemistry between two characters in a book as well as in this.
Yeah.
And this, I hope, doesn't get like, you know, writers don't get worried about the fact that they're touching upon a subject that might lead to controversies. Because we have that. It's us. We have so many stories to tell.
Yeah.
And I just hope we don't get stuck in restaurants and coffee shops.
I'm reading Stephen Fry's Mythos, which is him explaining Greek mythology. But because it's Stephen Fry, it is fucking funny. Like, I am laughing so hard while I'm reading about very, very fucked up gods and goddesses, which is exactly even Indian mythology.
Yeah. Right?
You know why Draupadi marries all five of them?
Yeah, because Kunti is like, I got you something, but I'll split it in the
first.
Share it. I'm like, woman.
And then they're like, but it's a woman. And... okay, cool.
Yeah, it's a little but
like legit. There is a scene where they are all like,
okay.
Oh God.
It's very. But then again, like even though if it's a version, the fact that there has to be conversation about it.
Yeah.
People, I'm just hoping that that's not the case where.
Yeah.
People don't write versions of their own, right? Because it's mythology is my favorite.
But I want to read a funny version of Mahabharata.
Oh my god, I would, guys, if imagine Jaane Bhi Do Yaro's Mahabharat scene.
Yeah.
If it releases today, they will all be shot when it's the funniest scene in the world. So if written now a funny version, I don't know.
So is Chitra Banerjee Divakaruni your favorite Indian author?
I don't know about that, but this book, man, it's one of those things which I just couldn't.
Who's your favorite?
Oh, Salman Rushdie.
I love him.
I know how I sound. I don't know her big words, but that man just leaves me with a visual.
Oh my god.
That is so gorgeous that he's just
kids.
He is like, my god.
I want the clown in the
what
book.
What about from like the newer crop, like a Jerry Pinto, Manu Joseph?
I think while we are talking about interesting characters and their like, you know, questionable relationships, Amitav Ghosh.
Oh my god, yeah.
His Ibis trilogy, which is The Sea of Poppies, Rivers of Smoke and Flood of Fires. It's about the opium wars, right?
Mm.
And it's what I like about Amitav Ghosh generally as a writer is that he writes colonial historical accounts, but he always writes it not from the point of view of the story, but he writes it from the point of view of the
character.
And they're always living on the fringes of society, the people who would be like somehow deeply entrenched with things that are happening. Like the opium wars were these wars fought between China and Britain. And one of the ways in which it was about trade and basically how the, you know, like a lot of, there was unequal trade between the two nations. And what was happening is that the British were using opium as like a tool to sort of... corrupt Chinese society so that the trade reverses somehow.
Yeah, also, monetarily made sense, yet the soil was dying though.
Who was doing this opium trade? Indians, because it was the British East India Company that was producing the opium and shipping it. And the story is told from the point of view of multiple characters, but there's one character who Devika, I think her name is, or if I'm not wrong.
I'll get to my Amitav Ghosh favorite.
Okay. So it's from the point of view of Devika, and she, like, her mother dies and then she is married to a guy who is impotent. So they give her some opium so that she passes out, and then her brother-in-law consummates the marriage on behalf of her brother, and the brother eventually dies, and she's going for sati. And oh my god, the complexity.
What is happening?
It spirals out of control.
This is why it is important to have sex before marriage.
Yes. We advocate openly.
Very important. But Amitav Ghosh's, I've actually read only one. I think it was very strange because I usually end up going on a biography zone. So someone recommended Amitav Ghosh's The Hungry Tide. And I was very like, mujhe nahi padna types. And I started reading, couldn't stop.
Yeah.
I think the lead's name is Piali, right?
Piali, yeah.
Oh man, yeah. I loved her character. As you. Also, I've never seen a more mature writer. Expression or a mature way of dealing with Piali, who seems like an upper class person, yeah, and her relationship with the guy who was a regular at the Tide. These classes are so different, but you can totally, it totally makes sense. It totally makes sense that they're attracted to each other in whatever levels,
yeah,
which I really like. I think, by the way, you're talking, he really manages that very well. And the book is also very gripping. And oh my God, I feel like the tiger is always there.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm waiting for it to attack.
It's set in the Sundarbans.
Yeah, which also.
Which is also something we don't know much about. Like, we don't know our entire geography and topography very closely. And this, like, really talks about all the issues that are with the area, you know, in fiction.
Absolutely,
which is very interesting.
Especially, you know, there was one point where I think they spoke about the people who are affected by the fact that the tiger comes at any point and it's dangerous. Having said that, they don't believe, there is a section that doesn't believe in hurting or killing it. So, which is such a strange like, your everyday problem is mera coffee powder khatam ho gaya, and here these people are like, tiger ko maregi nahi. I'm like, what is this problem you're facing and why am I totally invested in this? So,
yeah.
I was super happy because of that.
Yeah.
Piali. Piali, na? I thought I was Piali, just saying. Okay.
I wrote har Saturday ko Piali. Har Saturday.
Hungry Piali.
Yeah. Oh my God!
She should have been thirsty tied as
well. Oh, thirsty tied! Because she's a tigress. Anyway, sorry. Piali the tiger.
Okay.
You should stop.
Okay. One more author I want to talk about, because we've never spoken about him and I'm too excited to talk about him that I may not get words and I may fumble and blur, but I love him. I have a big crush on him. This is Aatish Taseer. A little bit about Aatish Taseer. He is the son of... He's very hot.
That's unbelievable. Let's begin with what is important.
Cultured
guys. We'll put up a photo.
Yes, please. We will. Supers will be ready. Yeah. Please continue.
Yeah, see, my heart is already thumping.
Yeah, look at her face. It's her face is not, her face is pink.
Yeah.
For the next 3 days.
Aatish.
Aatish, are you serious?
Aatish Bazik.
Where is Sudeep when you need him?
Yeah.
Who's Sudeep? Aatish Taseer is the son of a very well-known Indian.
Sorry, we shouldn't stop you. Aatish Taseer is the son
not
of...
approve of this humor.
We will not.
He's the son of this very famous Indian journalist, political journalist called Tavleen Singh. And Salman Taseer, the late Salman Taseer, was a Pakistani politician. He was assassinated. And
Of course. Well, have any of them lived long enough to die of old age? Yeah. Anyway,
it's like a thing.
Yeah, he was a learned Pakistani politician, which is what the problem was, I suppose. But he... So he grew up in India and London because he couldn't really be an Indian citizen. I mean, because, you know, like...
Can you be a literary author?
Exactly.
Yeah, like his parents weren't married. So there were issues. You know, he was always troubled. His childhood was always troubled. And he wrote a lot of poetry. So I met him like many, many years ago.
Oh! The plot thickens. Aatish ke saath Taseer.
God.
Sangarsh in her pants, guys. Sangarsh in her pants.
Exactly. Aatish, if you're listening.
She's married.
Yeah, but I'm not.
Neither am I.
Oh, we could totally be the Taseers to your Aatish.
Guys, he's kind of committed right there. Now. Please, like, hold on to your panties. Anyway, so he wrote two books that I want to talk about. He's also the guy who introduced me to Manto because he wrote this amazing translation of Manto's short stories, which I discovered, and that's how I discovered Manto. But he also wrote this another book called Stranger to History, which was highly lauded to be this very interesting book about what it's like to be a person who's not allowed to get in touch with his own legacy and history. Because he, I mean, come on, think about it. India, Pakistan, mother, father, very difficult, very tumultuous time, right? He grew up in London away from everything that would culturally be him. And he came from a lineage which was very cultural, like father, very well-respected politician, very proud Pakistani, mother, very proud Indian. Very difficult sort of to live up to I that know. Legacy and also understand it, right? So Stranger to History is a very personal memoir. So Aatish's other book, other than Stranger to History, is Temple Goers, which was his first novel, actually. And V.S. Naipaul read that. He was like, oh my God, this guy is going to be big.
Really? V.S. Naipaul liked it?
Yeah. Temple Goers is about the class of people in Delhi who like to go to temples.
This Delhi is really working for Sharin.
Yeah.
Anything
yeah,
in Chennai, I mean, she's like, how are you moving to Delhi and then it's happening?
I'll tell you why. I know she's might be Chandigarh. Biased. That is it. Okay. That's what I know. That's what I've seen. So I connect with these stories a bit more, and which is why I've read all these.
But you connect more with Aatish, right?
Yeah, Aatish unfortunately has let go of his Indian identity and passport completely and moved to the US.
Good
and
for him.
Huge article and about why he's abandoned or why we have abandoned him. And I'm like, I never did that.
You know, it's the luxury. If you have two passports, it's very interesting.
Give me one chance. Speaking of Indian authors.
Yes.
That we love.
Now it's time for
Anuya's time.
Yeah. But I don't love him the way Sharin loves.
She loves him.
I don't think it's possible.
You have his babies. It's not even you want his babies.
They are inside her already.
Yeah, exactly. Ho gaya.
Yes, I feel them moving.
My favorite Indian author is Samit Basu. I've said this like 15 times. I've met him and I'm like. When I met him for the first time, it was during, and I'm going to now talk about both of their work because I feel like they were very instrumental in this. Even though I feel like they haven't got their due, Samit Basu and Sidhan Vadukut were very, very, the early 2000s literature that came out of India, right? And by literature, which straddled popular culture. So it was going to be, so it's really, really well written, fun books. Huh. And I went for Doc One's launch during the Kalagoda Festival, Arts Festival that happened. And Samit Basu was there to launch Doc with Sidhan Vadukut. Sidhan is a very popular internet figure. Mm. Everybody knows who he is.
He's a meme. Following.
Yeah, he's a really, really funny man. Lives in London again. Writes for me.
These people with London? Yeah. Are you ready?
He wrote Dork, which was about an engineering MBA kid. And he had this very unique Sidhan Vadukut voice, which was like, you know, irony, satire, but at the same time creating a character that you feel empathize with, feel bad for. You understand the kind of world he's trapped in. You understand the kind of pressure he's under. But you can also make fun of that situation. So that way, Dork 1 and 2, which I've read, were really good books. Even though I didn't relate to it much because I didn't do the engineering.
Yeah, this was
Yeah.
Oh my God.
Yeah, I think Doc was before.
It's London written Lakhomek.
Before Three Idiots, there was Doc. Yeah. You know, it's just so smart that maybe it's never going to be 5 points somewhere. It's very smart, right? And then at the same time, Samit Basu wrote the Sumukhi trilogy, Sumukhi Prophecies, the Game World trilogy, which was about, according to me, the best fantasy fiction to come out of India. And it is just super, and he was very clearly inspired by Terry Pratchett. What I love about it is it's not 2,000 books, it's 3 books.
Hello.
They have Aishwarya Rai jokes in there.
What?
Yeah. Yeah. He calls a duck Aishwarya the duck. And there is another fellow whose name is Harohan. H-R-O-H-A-N. And he has an extra finger, I think. Okay. So he's taken all of that, but he's painted this superb world where he's taken Indian mythology, like the superior race is called the Ravians, okay, the sun race. So they are sort of like the elves.
Yeah.
But he's taken all of that and he's twisted it around in a way where you don't know what's going to happen. It's beautifully written. The world is amazing. I have reread all 3 books. Sumukhi Prophecy. What's the second one called? Manticore Secrets and the Unbaba Revelations, they are called. Superb books.
I'm going to walk away with so much to
And then we met him when we did Clueless Critic and he signed this copy of Turbulence, which was his other series, which I don't really like, but Samit Basu was there and he was signing, so I took it.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. He drew me an elephant. Thank you, Samit.
That's cute. Samit.
please.
So cute he is. I can't.
If you like fantasy fiction, yeah. I cannot stress on Sumukhi and Prophecies.
Okay, so Samet Basu, who. Aatish or Taslam. Aatish or Taseer. Sorry. And of course. Amitav Ghosh, CEO of Poppies, have to finish.
Yeah. Oh,
this is so much information. You guys are crazy.
We are.
This is why I'm nervous when I come in this.
Why?
Because you guys know so much.
Sidhan has written a book called Bombay Fever, which I tried reading and I didn't like it at all.
It's about contagion. Like
yeah. He's trying very hard to write a medical drama. And I feel like he's checking, oh, ye trope ho gaya. Sorry, Sidhan. Love you, buddy. Love you. But
don't be a Sanjeevni.
Don't do medical.
Oh my god. Oh my god, what a recall. You know, the opening shot of Sanjeevi was exactly like the opening shot of ER.
Shit. Yeah.
I was like, kya ho raha hai? Yeah. Basketball kaise khel rahe? Doctors India mein basketball khelte hai. Haan, please jhoot bolo.
Doctors India mein heart khelte hai.
Tu bhi fake ho, main bhi fake ho.
Chalo, let's do the clickbait round.
Okay, yes. Yeah. So, we've come to our most interesting part of the show, which is the clickbait round. We thought we'll do something interesting with Sumukhi, since Sumukhi is so good at doing characters. We thought,
yay! Oh shit! Okay. Yeah. Okay. Yay, okay. Fuck. Okay.
So Sumukhi, this is what we're gonna do.
Right.
We're going to throw characters at you.
Okay.
You need to say any line.
Okay.
Like
and how they would do it.
Okay. Give me an example.
Or give her a line.
Yeah. Okay. Whatever. Whichever.
Ye haath humko de de Thakur.
Okay.
In the voice of say Chacha Chaudhary.
Oh, okay. But like what I think is Chacha.
Yeah, of course.
Because we don't know Chacha.
Exactly.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, he's not had cold coffee with us yet.
Yes.
Huh. But you can choose the line.
But he's Chacha Chaudhary. So he'll have chai, no? Chai Chaudhary.
I also think Chacha Chaudhary. I don't know why I keep thinking Chacha Chaudhary as a chokidar ka accent.
Yeah? Go for it.
Well, yeah.
Yeah.
Thakur. Okay, so the first character you have to do is Mowgli.
Okay, and the line, give me a line.
Yeah, Dhamko Dede Thakur. You want another line?
Okay, I'm going to.
Or just be Mowgli, man.
Yeah, I'm
just
going to Mowgli. Do like Mowgli ka this also, okay?
Yeah, you're Mowgli. You're in the jungle.
Yeah, and I'm running.
Okay. Chaddi
ban ke phool khilaye, phool khilaye. Ki haath humko Dede Thakur. Bagheera, haath nahi mila mujhe Thakur se. Thakur bhi pichi.
Okay, now, same,
wow.
Sabu.
Good evening. Chacha Chaudhary sent me, if you could please give me the heart, Mr. Thakur.
No, I don't want to give it to you.
I just need it right now.
No, Dana Sale!
I'm sorry, I lost my cool. For me, Sabu is very...
Yeah. In Saturn.
Sabu is very like Hulk.
Jupiter.
He's very Hulk. He loses shit whenever. For me, Sabu is Hulk.
He's instant Hulk, but yeah. Instant Hulk, instant out.
Exactly, yeah. Bipolar Hulk.
Yeah.
Then?
Next is Sherlock Holmes.
Oh.
And I'm, you're I'm a pipe? Pipe.
Yeah, oh, fuck. No,
you know, can take this as a pipe.
This is Robert Downey Jr. wala.
Whatever you want.
More clickbaity. Okay. Looking for a hand. Seems to be with you, Thakur. Do you want to cut it? Or do you want to... Give it. I think Sherlock is quite lame. Wow. Clearly, I have no opinion on Sherlock.
I think you will like the next one.
Yeah.
Nancy Drew.
Oh my god! Sherlock, Ned's really excited about extra hands. I need it right now. After that, I'm gonna go on a holiday because all my adventures start on a holiday, okay? I'm gonna go on a holiday and then there's gonna be a case that I'm gonna solve. But Neddy Doodle Doo wants your hat. So give it to me. Give it to me. Come on.
Oh my god.
Hamlet.
Oh fuck. Taco! Where art the drop of blood thou? Because it's fallen. Because your hands are fall.
What?
Ow. I always think Shakespeare ends with ow. Just saying.
Ow.
Yeah. I think Shakespeare No one ever told this for Shakespeare. I'm doing this. Shakespeare, you're welcome.
Okay, that brings us to the end. Exactly. I'm so sad.
I know. Oh. As Shakespeare would say.
Of a really fun podcast.
Thank you so much, Sumukhi.
Sharin, what did you call it? The best, great podcast.
Great podcast. See what I tell you. I told you, right? If you're here with us, it's going to be amazing.
Also, guys, just please hang out with people who read, okay? I know it's too much, but they really give great recommendations. Also, they also go really horny about writers.
And someone should be like, wow, kya likhti hai? Bahut hot hai.
Haan, bahut hot hai.
You know, exactly.
Oh, look at her Instagram followers because she has a 28-inch waist, 24-inch.
Yeah, I say about literary lace. This is literally lace.
Okay. Yeah. Next week, please let us know, who would you like to be literally laid with?
In the comment section.
In the comment section, not call us. That's weird.
Yeah, don't do that.
Okay, that's weird.
Like, you can also pick other cool women that you'd like to. Actually, you know what? Don't.
Just literally.
This is going into a very weird direction.
Yeah, it would be like, yeah, exactly.
Yeah, no. Just.
But thank you so much, guys. You guys have made me smarter.
Literally hug.
Give a literally hug.
But thank you so much, guys.
Thank you for coming.
I am now a wiser person after this.
I want to now read this book.
This book is insane. Yes. You guys have to. Okay, also please like, share and subscribe this video because people need to start reading Indian fiction. I'm just a little irritated. All of these Dan Browns and whatnots are getting all the fame and none of us are. So it's time for us to get the fame.
Yeah. Woo! Hey, no.